Good morning, children. Today we will study characteristics of sound. Two different sounds can be identified. Two different sounds can be identified by three following characteristics. Number one, loudness. Second, pitch or shrillness. Third, quality or timbre. These are three characteristics of sound by which we can distinguish two different sound or identify two different sound. First, loudness. Loudness of sound depends on amplitude. Loudness of sound depends on amplitude. Loudness is the property. Loudness is the property or characteristics of sound by which loud sound can be distinguished from a faint one. Loud sound can be distinguished from a faint sound, both having the same pitch and same quality. Quality and pitch of two sounds are same, but amplitudes are different. Then we can identify the two sound as per loudness, as per loudness. Two sound waves produced by same tuning fork. So frequency will be same and wave pattern will be same. But when we strike hard and harder, then amplitude will be different. Amplitude will be different, but frequency and waveform will be same. See, in displacement time graph, first, amplitude is small, and second, amplitude is large. So first, sound is produced is soft, and second, sound is produced is loud. So it is clear that loudness of sound depends on amplitude. Amplitude is small, sound is soft. Amplitude is large, sound is loud. So loudness is the characteristic of sound by which two sounds can be identified, having the same pitch and same waveform. Now, unit of loudness is phon, 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 and decibel, decibel, decibel. It is represented by a small d and capital B, decibel, a small d and capital B. Pin drop silence is considered to be 0 decibel. Pin drop silence is considered to be 0 decibel. Sound level above the 120 decibel is considered to be noise. Sound level or loudness of sound above 120 decibel is considered to be noise. Factors affecting the loudness of sound. Factors affecting the loudness of sound. There are five factors. There are five factors affecting the loudness of sound. First, amplitude of sound. Second, distance of observer from source of sound. Third, density of sound. Fourth, surface area of vibrating body. And five, presence of resonance body. First, amplitude. Loudness depends on amplitude. Loudness is directly proportional to a square of amplitude. Loudness is directly proportional to a square of amplitude. L, loudness, and A, amplitude. So L is directly proportional to A square. This means that directly proportional means that amplitude increases, loudness increases. But a square of amplitude, this means that when amplitude increases two times, loudness increases four times. If amplitude increases three times, loudness increases nine times. If amplitude increases five times, loudness increases 25 times. 5 square. 25 times. Next, distance of observer from source of sound. Distance of observer from source of sound. Loudness is inversely proportional to a square of distance. A square of distance. L proportional 1 by D square. This means that distance of observer from source of sound decreases, loudness increases. Or distance of observer from source of sound increases, loudness decreases, but square times. This means that distance of observer from source of sound increases two times, then loudness decreases 1/4 times. If distance of observer from source of sound increases three times, then loudness decreases 1/9 times, and so on. Next, surface area of vibrating body. Surface area of vibrating body increases, loudness increases. If you beat a small table and a large table, then you will observe that a small table produces feeble sound while large table produces loud sound. Reason is, surface area of large table having large surface. This means that surface area of vibrating body increases, loudness increases. Next, density of medium. Density of medium increases, loudness increases. Density of medium increases, loudness increases. We know that sound wave travel in medium. If you speak in air and in water, then you will observe that in water, loudness, more loud sound is produced because density of water is more than air. So, density of medium increases, loudness increases. Last, presence of vibrating body. Due to presence of vibrating body, loudness increases. When vibrating body, resonant body are present, near the vibrating body, then resonant body start vibrating under the resonance with large amplitude and produces loud sound. So, presence of resonant body produces large sound. Next characteristic, pitch or shrillness. Pitch of a note depend on frequency of sound. Pitch depends on frequency of sound. If the pitch is high, sound is shrill. If pitch is low, the sound is flat. See in the figure, these are produced by two different tuning forks. These sound waves are produced by two different tuning forks. One having 256 Hz frequency and next having 512 Hz frequency. So, amplitude, both having the same amplitude, but frequencies are different. First figure shows low pitch means less frequency, low pitch note, so flat sound is produced. And second shows high pitch note because of large number of frequency, and therefore sound is shrill. So shrill sound is produced. Low pitch note, flat sound is produced. High pitch note, shrill sound is produced. Frequency of vibration increases. Frequency of vibration of a body increases. Pitch becomes shriller and shriller. So, pitch depends on frequency. Loudness depends on amplitude. Pitch depends on frequency. The voice of woman is of higher pitch than that of a man. Means the sound wave produced by woman having larger frequency or high frequency than the sound is produced by man. In a string instrument, the pitch can be increased first by increasing tension of a string. Second, by decreasing thickness or radius of a string. By decreasing thickness or radius of a string. And third, by plucking the string at the end position of the string. So there are three ways by which we can increase the pitch of a string instrument. First, by increasing the tension of a string. Second, by decreasing the thickness of a string. And third, by plucking the string at the end position or by changing the position of plucking. In flute or wind instrument, in flute or wind instrument, pitch is increasing. Pitch is increasing or pitch increases by closing some more holes, so that the length of vibrating air column increases. This means that length of vibrating air column increases by closing some more holes, pitch increases. Next, character of sound, characteristics of sound is quality or timbre. Quality of musical instrument sound depends on the waveform. Quality of musical sound or musical instrument sound depends on the waveform. Quality is the characteristics of sound which distinguishes the two sounds of the same loudness and same pitch but emitted by two different instruments. Sound emitted by two different instrument. See in the figure, first sound waveform is of tuning fork and second is of guitar. So sound of tuning fork and sound of guitar. See in the figure, amplitude, both waveforms having same amplitude and same frequency, that is same loudness and same pitch. But what are different? Different is waveform. And by using waveform, we can distinguish two different sound emitted by two different musical instrument. In this way, two different sound can be distinguished by using three characteristics of sound: loudness, pitch and quality or timbre.